Do you think that the Dominican government should have diplomatic relations with its neighbor Cuba? And if so, how far or how full should those relations be?
Él considera que los Estados Unidos deben tener relaciones con Rusia.
Do you feel that the United States should have relations with Cuba, with Russia?
Well, we do.
Entonces, prefiero no contestar la pregunta.
Then the general would rather not answer the question.
What, if any, mistakes do you think that your father made when he headed the government?
Creo que como todos los humanos, cometió algunos errores. Pero no tan grande como algunos errores que ha cometido el gobierno de los Estados Unidos en los últimos años.
The general feels that, like all humans, his father made some mistakes, but not as great as some that have been made in recent years by the United States government.
Well, the general refers to the United States government specifically. What mistakes does he think that the United States government has made?
Algunos en América Latina.
Some in Latin America.
Especialmente.
Especially.
No es necesario comentarles cuáles.
It's needless to comment which they are.
Later. After carrying the country through its present crisis, what plans do you have for yourself?
Hasta después de las elecciones, no podré hacer ningún plan definitivo.
Well, the general can make no definite plans until after the election.
What reforms have been instituted in your military intelligence agency, SIM?
Se han hecho bastantes reformas técnicas y se piensan hacer más reformas. O sea, tecnificar más los servicios para que puedan rendir una labor más eficiente.
Considerable reform has been accomplished, and more is, technical reforms are planned so as to develop a higher type of technical work on it. Part of this service.
How do you plan to maintain the balance between a true liberalization of your security service and the prevention of communism and other threats to the government?
Tendremos que hacerlo. Mantener el orden y la libertad dentro del orden necesario para mantener la prosperidad del país.
We will have to do it. Maintain, preserve order, and preserve freedom within order, so as to ensure the prosperity of the country, which is essential.
Esta mañana recibí a miembros de la oposición del Partido Revolucionario y les expresé esto mismo, y ellos parecen estar de acuerdo que la libertad debe ser ejercida manteniendo el orden en el país.
This morning, General Trujillo received members of the Dominican Revolutionary Party and expressed to them the same ideas that he has just stated. And they seem to agree that liberty, freedom should be exercised within the bounds of order, the preservation of peace and order.
Are the present economic sanctions imposed by the OAS contributing to the turmoil inside the Dominican Republic?
Aunque las sanciones afectan el buen desenvolvimiento comercial del país, indudablemente, no creo que eso tenga relación con las recientes turbas que incendiaron Radio Caribe y cometieron un sinnúmero de atropellos en las calles de Ciudad Trujillo.
Although sanctions do affect the adequate development of commercial life in the Republic, the General does not feel that they had anything to do with those outbreaks of violence on the part of those mobs that burned Radio Caribe and committed other acts of violence in the streets in the last few days.
Well, would the removal of the sanctions contribute anything to the present situation in the country?
Indudablemente que mejorarían el aspecto económico y comercial del país, el cual actualmente afecta inclusive a la población civil y los trabajadores porque han tenido que hacerse restricciones en cuanto a obras públicas para asumir una actitud conservadora en cuanto a la economía.
Restoring, the suspension of the sanctions would doubtless help restore the normal development of commercial life in the country. And it would have general repercussion on conditions because those sanctions affect the people generally, including the labor classes, particularly because restrictions have had to be imposed on public works, limitations of public works, in order to keep garment expenses within reasonable conservative boundaries.
General, what do you believe the government of the United States could do to help you in your problem?
Lo mismo que podría hacer con todos los países latinoamericanos. Y me parece que eso es mejor que lo tratasen por organismos internacionales.
The same that they could do for other Latin American countries. And General Trujillo feels that that subject might be better discussed with international organizations.
General Trujillo, thank you very much. Muchas gracias. General Trujillo, do you think more reforms are needed? And if so, what should they be? What, if any, mistakes did your father make when he was head of the Dominican Republic? What, if any, mistakes did your father make when he ran the government? What are the dangers, external and internal, that the Dominican Republic faces today? How much of a role will the Trujillo family play in the present government? Well, how much of a role will the Trujillo family play in any new government that's formed after the elections? You have been accused of having anti-American feeling. You have been accused in the past of having anti-American feelings. Are you against the United States? Do you feel bitter about the United States? Since the opposition parties have returned to the Dominican Republic, violence has been allowed to... Since the opposition parties have returned to the Dominican Republic, violence has flared. If this violence continues, will these parties be allowed to continue operating? Do you think that the recent violence was instituted by the communists? And if so, were they Dominican communists or communists from the outside? Were they Cuban communists? After carrying the country through its present crisis, what are your plans? What plans do you have for yourself after you carry the country through its present crisis? The new government has not yet stated any policy or policies of nationalization. Do you think they should? What should be nationalized? How do you feel personally about nationalization? Cut for a second, Herb. General, what reforms have been instituted in the military intelligence agency, SIM?
Repeat, Stan.
General, what... General Trujillo, are you satisfied with the reforms that President Balaguer has thus far instituted?
Sí, estoy muy satisfecho y muy conforme.
The general is very well satisfied and agreeable.
Do you think that more reforms are needed, and if so, what should they be?
Considero que una reforma muy importante que está pendiente es la reforma agraria.
The general considers that a very important reform which is still pending is the agrarian reform, the agricultural reform.
Well, in addition to the agrarian or agricultural reform, does he have any other ideas about reforms that are needed in the country?
El presidente está estudiando varias reformas. Por eso no es necesario que yo haga ningún comentario al respecto.
The president has several reforms under consideration. Therefore, the general feels that it's not proper for him to comment on that subject.
Does General Trujillo, do you think that the United States government is presently making any mistakes in relation to the Dominican Republic?
No creo que todavía ha habido nada que yo considere poco satisfactorio.
General doesn't feel that there has been anything thus far that he considers not satisfactory.
What, if any, are the dangers, external or internal, that the Dominican Republic faces today?
En las actuales circunstancias pueden presentarse algunos disturbios nacionales, como ya vimos en días pasados, pero eso lógicamente está sucediendo en muchos países en el mundo.
Under the present circumstances, some domestic disturbance may take place, like we saw, for instance, a few days ago. But that is not unusual in the world at this moment. It's happening in many places.
Does the general feel that the government, the present government, can handle these disturbances, this violence that has taken place?
Estoy seguro.
It's certain.
What are your feelings, sir, about President Balaguer's announcement that he doesn't plan to run for re-election next year?
Ese anuncio fue sorpresivo para mí.
That announcement was a surprise to General Trujillo.
Y ojalá reconsiderara esta cuestión.
General Trujillo hopes that he may reconsider his position.
General, how much of a role will the Trujillo family, your family, play in the new government?
Él se refiere al actual gobierno o a un gobierno en el futuro, si es que gana el Partido Dominicano las elecciones.
Do you mean the present government, now holding office, or a future government in case the Dominican Party should win the coming election?
Well, let's take that A and B. I mean the present government and, say, a future government that may come into power.
Bueno, en la actualidad, la posición más importante la ocupo yo, de mi familia.
At the present moment, General Trujillo occupies the most outstanding position among all members of his family.
Indudablemente que yo no puedo hablar en nombre de toda la familia Trujillo.
Of course, General can't speak for the entire Trujillo family.
Eso es todo lo que tengo que
that is all that he wishes to state on the subject.
General, you have been accused in the past of having anti-American feelings. How do you feel about the United States government, and what are your feelings about the new administration?
Yo pienso que es muy prematuro opinar con respecto a la nueva administración, aunque no he sido partidario nunca de hablar de los gobiernos de otros países para no inmiscuirme en la política ajena. Creo y espero, para el bien de los Estados Unidos, que sea una buena administración, como parece que va a serlo.
The general feels that it is rather premature to comment on what the characteristics of the present U.S. government are. He would feel generally that he would like to refrain from commenting on the governments of other countries as a sign of his respect for the internal affairs of other countries. The general does believe and hope that the present United States administration may turn out to be a good one, as it apparently is showing to be.
Well, General, let me ask you, or put the question to you this way. Do you hold any anti-American feeling?
Yo expresé en la conferencia de prensa que no tenía ningún sentimiento anti-norteamericano ni anti-nadie. Soy simplemente pro-dominicano.
General Trujillo stated at a recent a press conference that he does not entertain any anti-American or anti-anybody feelings, that he is merely pro-Dominican.
Since the opposition parties have been allowed to return to this country, violence has flared. If this violence continues, will the political party or parties responsible be outlawed?
Me parece que el honorable señor presidente de la República, si se llega a comprobar la participación de determinado partido en los disturbios ocurridos, puede erradicar del país ese partido.
The general feels that His Excellency the President may, if and when it should be established that a certain party has been contributory to the recent outbreak of violence, may eradicate that party from the country.
General, do you think that the recent violence was instituted by the communists? If so, were these Dominican communists or Cuban communists, communists from the outside?
No, esto fue nacional. Esto me parece que tiene raíces
General Trujillo, do you think that the recent violence was instituted by the communists?
Lo que puedo decirle es que llevaban bandera roja y negra.
All the general can say is they were carrying red and black banners.
Que es la bandera pro-castrista.
Which is the pro-Castro banner.
Have you had any other evidence of pro-Castro activity in the Dominican Republic?
Solo sabemos que el Movimiento Popular Dominicano tiene contactos en Cuba.
All that we know is that the Movimiento Popular Dominicano, the Dominican Popular Movement, has contacts in Cuba, connections in Cuba.
Since the assassination of your father, have there been Dominican communists who have come to the surface? That is, do you have a Dominican Communist Party or a communist cell in this country?
Si el Movimiento Popular Dominicano es comunista, creo que sí que existen células comunistas. Ahora, lo que había es que determinar si el Movimiento Popular Dominicano es o no es comunista.
If the Dominican Popular Movement, the MPD, is communist, then, of course, there are Dominican communist cells. However, what remains to be determined is whether or not the MPD is a communist movement.
Eso se puede saber claramente. Si se puede determinar que el gobierno del señor Fidel Castro es comunista, entonces, si el gobierno de Fidel Castro es comunista, muy probablemente el Movimiento Popular Dominicano sea de tendencias comunistas, porque estamos en la completa seguridad de que son simpatizadores de el doctor Fidel Castro.
The way to determine that question is first to determine whether or not the Fidel Castro's regime is communist. If it is, then the MPD probably has communist tendencies, because it is known that they sympathize with the Dr. Castro's regime.
How strong do you think the MPD's support is in this country?
Ha crecido bastante en los últimos tiempos.
It has grown considerably in recent times.
Why?
Porque han trabajado con ahínco y parece que la ideología comunista se esparce fácilmente.
For one thing, they have worked hard, stubbornly, and then also the communist ideas seem to spread easily.
The government has always maintained that the Dominican people were happy, that is, under your father's regime, that there was no opposition to your father, no unrest in the country. If this is or was the case, how do you explain the recent demonstrations against the government and the many Dominicans lining up to register as members of the present three political parties?
Mi padre nunca conversó conmigo en este sentido, o mejor dicho, nunca me dijo que no teníamos en el país oposición interna. Lo que sí, él siempre consideró que contaba con la mayoría del pueblo dominicano. Y yo también considero que es así.
General Trujillo's father never discussed these subjects specifically with General Trujillo. He never told him that there was no opposition in the country. He did maintain that the great majority of the Dominican people were on his side, and General Trujillo personally feels the same way.
But, sir, how do you explain the recent demonstrations and those people in your country who are now starting to register as members of the three new political parties?
Siempre lo nuevo tiene una atracción. Eso es indudable.
What is, oh, excuse me.
Y considero que muchos se afiliarán al partido. Pero, a pesar de eso, considero que el Partido Dominicano tendrá una gran mayoría.
New things always attract people. And that will probably be the case with these new parties. But General Trujillo feels that in any event, the Dominican Party will continue to have a large majority.
Quiero significarle que a pesar de que en las turbas habían unas 800 personas, muchas de ellas se unieron solamente para cometer actos de bandolerismo, no por ideologías extrañas, sino incitados por instigadores especializados. Y este caso se presentó a raíz de la muerte de mi padre, en el cual muchas turbas de 1,000 y 2,000 personas salieron pidiendo venganza por la muerte de mi padre, y como sabíamos que era para cometer actos de pillaje y bandolerismo, se les persuadió por medio de bocinas para que se retiraran tranquilamente a sus hogares.
Although there were some 800 persons in the group that took part in the recent disturbance, it should be noted that many did not take part in that mob because of any political ideologies.
But they... Now, wait a minute, Sam. Wait for... Would you look right at Mr. Jaffe, and when he tells you to go ahead...
I'll just nod like this. I'll just nod like this.
All right.
Well, look over at the general now, please. Just look at the general. Look at that fight.
While there were some 800 in this mob that promoted violence recently, it should be noted that many were not taking part in it because of any political ideologies, but they were rather instigated by vandalism and the desire to work destruction. Similar phenomena had been observed immediately following Generalissimo Trujillo's assassination, when big crowds gathered shouting for revenge. And realizing that what they really wanted was pilfering and destruction, they were persuaded to dissolve their demonstrations and go quietly home. General Trujillo doesn't know whether His Excellency the President has under consideration any plans for nationalization of any enterprises. It may well be that in the future it might be considered advisable to nationalize certain services or enterprises, although this will never be done by arbitrary methods, but rather following the lines that have been used in France and other civilized governments. This, of course, does not mean that any consideration has been given to immediate action along those lines. The general just merely wishes to make it plain that if the opportunity should come, the nationalization would be carried out rather along the methods used by certain European governments rather than by other governments who have gone about it in a rather arbitrary way.
Well, General, do you feel that nationalization of some of your enterprises would be a good idea in the future? And if so, what enterprises?
Aquí ha habido muy mala experiencia con empresas administradas por el Estado.
We have had very bad experience with enterprises handled by the government.
Por eso es mi modesta opinión de que más que una nacionalización podría considerarse una participación del Estado en determinadas industrias o empresas.
For that reason, the general's modest opinion would be that rather than outright nationalization, it might be preferable to work towards a participation of the government in certain industries or enterprises.
Tengo entendido que en Estados Unidos es así.
The general understands that this method is applied in the United States.
What, in your opinion, General, would you think should be the first enterprises to be nationalized, if this should come about?
Me parece que las principales fuentes de divisas del país, y indudablemente los servicios públicos, eso es obvio que debe pertenecer al Estado.
He thinks that mainly the main sources of foreign exchange, and particularly public utilities, that seems obvious. They should belong to the government.
After Karen.